Chapter 1, Overview of Computers. Now, let's see what is meant by computer. A computer is an advanced electronic device that accepts the input, processes the result, and produces the output. It takes raw data as input from the user and processes the data under the control of set of instruction which is called as program and gives the result. The result is called as output and saves the output for future use. Now, let's go for the representation. Process is a collection of instructions. The input will be given to the process. The input is called as data and the output will be produced on the screen. The output is called as information. So, the process gets the input, processes the data, executes the result and displays the output on the screen. Now, let's go for the basic functions of a computer. First function, input data. Input is the raw information entered into a computer from the input devices. It is a collection of letters, numbers, images, etc. Process. Process is the operation of data as per the given instruction. It is totally internal process of a computer. So, whatever result we are going to give, it will process and display the given output. Let's go for output. Output is the processing data given by the computer after data processing. Output is also called result. Example, monitor. We are going to view the output on the screen. So, output is a monitor. Storage. We can save the result in the storage devices for further use. Suppose we are going to execute experiment, we can save the experiment in internal storage or external storage. Now, let's see about a computer system. All the components of a computer system can be summarized with a simple equation. Computer system is equal to hardware plus software plus user. Software is a collection of programs. Hardware, the physical or internal components present is called as hardware. Combination of hardware and software and users is defined as computer system. Hardware is equal to internal devices plus peripheral devices. Peripheral devices is nothing but external devices such as keyboard, mouse, joystick are called as peripheral devices. All the physical parts of a computer or everything that we can touch are called as hardware. The devices which we can touch and realize is called hardware. Software is equal to programs. Software gives intelligence to the computer. Set of programs. Example, C, C++, Java. User is a person who operates with the computer. Now, let's move to the characteristics of computer. It can be classified into 8 different characteristics. Automatic, speed, accuracy, diligence, versatility, power of remembering, no IQ or intelligent quotient, no feeling. Now, let's see the first characteristics of a computer. Automatic. Computers are automatic machine because once started a job, they carry the job until it is finished without any human intervention. It performs only the activities that is instructed by an user. Speed. A computer can perform a huge task in a few seconds where a human being may take hours or even days to complete the same task. The speed of a computer is measured in the term of milliseconds, which is given as 10 power minus 3, microseconds, which is given as 10 power minus 6, nanoseconds, which is given as 10 power minus 9, and even the per seconds, 10 power minus 12. Accuracy. Accuracy is also called as correctness. In addition to being very fast, computers are very accurate. The degree of accuracy depends upon the design. The errors in a computer are due to human and inaccurate data. Example, if the data is given as wrong, then accuracy will be 0%. If the data is given correct, then the accuracy will be 100%. Diligence. Unlike human beings, a computer is free from monotony, tiredness, and lack of concentration. So a computer never gets tired or concentration will never die. It can work for hours without creating any error. If millions of calculations are to be performed, a computer will perform every calculation with the same accuracy. Due to the capability, it overpowers human being in routine type of work. Compared to human being, the computer performs best and accurate. Versatility. It means the capacity of to perform completely different types of tasks. So different tasks will be performed here. Example, at a moment, a computer can be used to draft a letter. Next moment, it can be used to print a document or play a music, etc. So it performs multiple tasks in a given time within a fraction of a second. Now, let's go for power of remembering. A computer can store and recall any amount of information because of its secondary memory storage. Once a program is completed, it will be stored in the primary or secondary memory. Whenever it is necessary, we can recall the data. No feeling. Computer has no feeling and no instincts because they are a machine. Compared to human beings, there is no feeling as such as human being, and all the work will be done exactly. No IQ. It is also called intelligence quotient. A computer is not a magical device. It possesses no intelligence of its own. Its IQ level is zero. It has to be told what to do and what a sequence. Hence, only the user can determine what task a computer will perform. A computer cannot take its own decision. Example, whenever we give any task to a computer, it automatically displays whatever task we are going to give, it will display the task. It will never think by its own. If we give 1 plus 1, automatically it displays as 2. A computer performs 5 major operations or functions. Accepts data or instructions as input. Stores the data and instruction. Processes the data as per the instruction. Controls all operations inside a computer. Gives the result in the form of an output. Now, let's go for the basic representation. So here, there are 5 different units. First one, input unit. Second one, output unit. Third one, storage unit. And next one is control central processing unit. So input unit, data will be given as input. In output unit, the output will be displayed on the screen. Information can be screened in the output. Storage unit consists of secondary storage and primary storage. Primary storage is an inbuilt storage. Secondary storage is a storage which can be made outside, example, pen drive, hard disk, etc. And central processing unit consists of control unit and arithmetic logic unit. Here, there are 2 different types of flow, data flow and control flow. Data flow is one, there will be continuous flow between the 2 devices. Control flow is one, it controls all the operations, which is indicated as dotted lines. Let's go for the explanation. Here, arrow marks indicate flow of instructions and data. Flow of instructions and data, and dotted lines indicate the control exercised by a control unit. So, the control will be transferring from the input unit to the output unit, and similarly from the all the devices. Here from secondary storage and primary storage, the data can be transferred. Similarly from storage unit to CPU, the data can be easily transferred. Now let's go to the first unit called as input unit. Input devices allows the users to enter the data, program and send it to the processing unit. Example, keyboard, mouse, scanner. Now whatever the input we are going to give, example, we are going to enter how are you. The same thing can be entered in a keyboard, and whatever we are going to enter in the keyboard with the help of an characters, it will be displayed on the screen. Let's go for the second one, storage unit. Storage is also called memory unit. Storage means a space where data can be stored. This storage unit is used for storing data and instructions before and after processing. Computer memory can be classified into two types, primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory can be classified into two different types, RAM and ROM. RAM stands for random access memory and ROM stands for read only memory. Secondary memory is one in which the storage is present on external devices. Example, hard disk, USB or pen drives. Now let's go for CPU. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. The Central Processing Unit takes the data and instruction from the storage unit and makes all calculations based upon the instruction given and type of data provided. It then sends back to the storage unit. It includes arithmetic logic unit and control unit. Arithmetic logic unit performs all the calculations such as arithmetic and logical. When we go for arithmetic, we have plus, minus, star and division. When we go for logical, we have AND operator, OR operator and NOT operator. Control unit controls the entire process of a system. Let's move to arithmetic logic unit. The name indicates arithmetic. We are going to perform arithmetic operations such as plus, minus, star, division. The term logic indicates logical operations such as AND operation or OR operation. All the calculations and comparisons based upon the instructions provided are carried out within an ALU. It performs various functions such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and logical operations such as greater than, less than or equal to. Now let's move to the control unit. Controls all the operations like input processing and output are performed by a control unit. It takes care of step by step processing of all the operations which is present inside a computer. Output unit. The input which is received from the keyboard will be displayed in the output unit. Example, monitor. Output devices show the processing data or information which can be processed with the help of a result. The devices are normally a monitor and a printer. Example, when we are going to type a document and give print, automatically the document which you have typed will be visible in the printout with the help of a printer. 2000 BC abacus. So this was introduced before 2500 BC. Abacus is the first known calculating machine used for counting the number of digits. Here in this diagram, abacus machine has been implemented which can be used to denote the number of digits. So based upon the number of coins, the digits can be calculated. It starts with 0 and finishes with 9. It is made up of beads strung on cords and it is used for simple arithmetic calculation. The cords corresponding to positions of a decimal digit. The beads represent the digit. Abacus was mainly used for addition and subtraction, and later it can be used for division and multiplication. Here based upon number of bits, we are going to count the arithmetic operation. Example, if we have only one bit, it represents 1. If we have 7 bits, it indicates 7. If we have 8 bits inserted, then the value will be 8. Based upon this, addition and subtraction can be implemented. Now, let's go for second one, Napier-Bones, which was introduced 1614 AD. This Napier-Bone concept was introduced to implement multiplication operation. So, based upon the multiplication operation, we are going to implement Napier-Bones, which consists of rows and columns. The numbers will be from 1 to 9 and horizontally 1 to 9 and vertically 1 to 9, where 0 is kept separate. The concept of this Napier-Bones is we are going to multiply each and every number. Example, 1 horizontal and 1 vertical, which is indicated by 1 into 1, the answer is 1. And next example, 1 in horizontal and here 8, 1 into 8, the answer will be 8. And 6 into 2, the answer will be 12. So for multiplication purpose, we go for Napier-Bones. The Napier-Bones was invented by John Napier, a Scottish mathematician, as an aid to multiplication. A set of bones consists of 9 rows, one of each digit, 1 through 9, and a constant row for a digit 0. A rod is similar to one column of a multiplication table. Let's move to the slide rule, which was invented in 1633 AD. The slide rule was invented by William. It is based on the principle that actual distance from the starting point of the rule is directly proportional to the logarithm of the numbers printed on the rule. So here is a slide rule. So the numbers will be placed from 1 to 9. The slide will be moving from horizontally and vertically according to the numbers. Based upon the numbers, the implementation can be done. The slide rule is embedded by two sets of scales that are joined together with a marginal space between them. There are two scales present which are joined together by a slide rule, where there will be some space between first scale and second scale. The suitable alliance of two scales enable the slide rule to perform multiplication and division by the method of addition and subtraction. Now, let's move to the rotating wheel calculator, which was introduced in 1642 AD. So here from this diagram, wheels will be present which will be rotating horizontally and it should be rotating vertically so that the distance can be calculated. The rotating wheel calculator was developed by a French philosopher, Blaise Pascal, using the simple components such as gears and levers. This is a predecessor to today's electronic calculator. He was inspired by the computation work of his father's job and devised this model. Based upon the father implementation, he has designed a new model based upon this. He was only 19 years old when he devised this model. Now, let's move to the difference engine, which was invented in 1822 AD. The difference engine was built by Charles Babbage, British mathematician and engineer, which mechanically calculated mathematical tables. Babbage is called father of today's computer. In 1833 AD, Lady Ada Lovelace, the first programmer, invented this difference engine. Now, let's move to the difference engine and analytical engine. So, here there is a model for difference engine and here there is a model for analytical engine. Now, next one is tabulating machine, which was invented in 1890 AD. This tabulating machine, all the calculations will be made and implemented based upon punched cards. So, the details will be displayed on the punched cards and based upon that, the processing can be done. A tabulating machine uses punched cards, which was designed by Hermann Hollerith and was called as Hollerith tabulating machine. This electronic machine is able to read the information on the punched cards and process it electronically. Generation of computers. Generation is characterized by a major technology development that fundamentally changed the way of computers operated. This helped to develop smaller, cheaper, powerful, efficient, and reliable devices. Now, let's move to the generation of computers. There are totally five different generations. First generation, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Let's start with the first generation. First generation was introduced in the year 1940 to 1956. Vacuum tubes were invented in first generation. The first generation computers used vacuum tubes for processing and magnetic drums for memory. So they used magnetic drums for storing the data. They were large in size, occupied lot of space and produced enormous heat. They were inexpensive to operate and consume large amount of electricity. So here in this representation, in earlier days, vacuum tubes were like this. So first one, second, third, fourth and fifth, the various models which was invented during the corresponding years. Sometimes the heat generated caused the computer to malfunction. Overheat may damage the system. First generation computers operated only on machine language. Input was based on punched cards and paper tape, and output was displayed in printouts. So input was given with the help of a punched cards. The data will be fed into the punched cards and displayed on the screen. First generation computers could solve only one problem at a time. Multiple tasks cannot be performed in first generation computer. The universal automatic computer, which is called as UNIVAC, and electronic numerical integrator and calculator, which is called as ENIAC, are the classical examples of first generation computing devices. Now let's move to the second generation. Second generation was introduced in 1956 to 1963. Transistors were introduced in second generation. The second generation computers replaced vacuum tubes by transistors. The transistor was far superior to vacuum tubes, allowing computers to become smaller, faster, cheaper, energy efficient, and more reliable than first generation counterparts. So this is an example for transistors, the various transistors. These transistors can be used in microprocessor for connecting two components, and it's a best storage area. The transistors also generated considerable heat that sometimes causes the computer to malfunction. But it is a vast improvement over the vacuum tubes. When compared to the first generation, this transistors produces heat lesser than the vacuum tubes. Second generation computers use punch cards for input and printouts for the output. Similar to first generation, the same punch cards can be used for input and output. Second generation computers use assembly languages which allow the programmers to specify the instruction in words. Higher level programming languages were also being developed at this time, such as early versions of COBOL, which stands for Common Oriented Business Oriented Language, and Fortran, Formula Translation. The computer stored the instruction in memory, which moved from the magnetic drum to magnetic core. So there's advancement in the memory technology. Now let's move to the third generation, which was invented and followed during the years 1964 to 1971. Integrated circuits was developed during the third generation. Transistors were small in size and placed on a silicon chip called ICs, which dramatically increased the speed and efficiency of computers. In this generation, keyboard and monitors were used instead of punched cards and printouts. So compared to first and second, third generation, there was a little improvement. Reason, keyboard and monitors were introduced. The computers were interfaced with an operating system which allows to solve many problems at a time. So this is an example for IC where multiple transistors were connected, and which this IC we can see in a microprocessor. Fourth generation computers. So it was invented from 1971 until now, we are using fourth generation computers. And microprocessor was invented in fourth generation. Thousands of IC were built into a single silicon chip called as microprocessor. This microprocessor will be present in the electronics departments, and as well as small computers become more and more powerful, they could be linked together to form a networks, which eventually lead to the development of internet. So this is an example for a microprocessor. So when we go for a laptop, motherboard and microprocessor will be fitted, which consists of a north bridge and a south bridge. Now let's move to the fifth generation, present and beyond. So artificial intelligence was invented during the fifth generation. So the different types of modern digital computers come under this category. Uses ultra large scale integrated technology that allows almost 10 million electronic components to be fabricated on a small chip. Very large storage capacity will be available. Artificial language can be developed from this, and the robotics can be designed using fifth generation computers. So this is an example for fifth generation. Robotics can be designed using fifth generation. So it can be designed using the concept of artificial intelligence. So artificial robots can be developed, where robotics is a special course in which it will be helpful for the robotics design. Classification of computers. Generally, a computer can be classified based upon three criteria: based on operating principle, based on application, and based on size and capability. Now let's move how it can be classified based upon the operating principle. It can be classified into three major types: analog computer, digital computer, hybrid computer. Now let's see what is analog computer. It represents data in the form of continuous electronic signals or electrical signals having a specific magnitude. Digital computers store and process the data in the form of digital form. Hybrid computers, combination of analog and digital, is called hybrid computers. Now let's move how it can be classified based upon the applications. It can be classified into two types: general purpose and special purpose. General purpose computers can work on all the environments, whereas special purpose computer can perform only one task at a time. Now let's move how to classify based upon size and capability. It can be classified into four different types: microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe computer, and supercomputers. Let's start with microcomputers. Designed to be used by the individuals, it has a microprocessor as its CPU. It performs operations such as inputting, storing, processing, outputting, controlling. Example: PCs, personal computer, laptop, and tab belongs to microcomputers. Now let's move to mini computers. Mini, the name itself indicates small, can handle more than data and more input and output than microcomputers. Medium sized computers, designed to serve multiple users simultaneously, used as server in LAN. It has large storage capacity and operates at a higher speed. Compared to other versions, mini computer speed will be more. Mainframe computers, very high speed and storage capacity. They are placed in a central location and can be connected to several other terminals. Larger and expensive, generally used in centralized database. Can also be used in controlling node in WAN, wide area network. Example: IBM 3000 series. Supercomputers, the fastest type of computer that can perform complex operations at very high speed. Fastest and most expensive machine. It is built of interconnecting hundreds of microprocessors. So it can be used in weather forecasting and military applications. It supports multi-processing and parallel processing. So multiple processing and parallel processing can be done together. Mainly used for weather forecasting, biomedical research and aircraft design. Example of supercomputers are Cray XMP. Now let's see about the overview classification. A computers can be classified into three different types: digital, analog, hybrid. Digital can be classified into further types: microcomputer, mainframe computer, supercomputer, mini computer. Microcomputer can be classified into desktop or PC. Applications of computer. First application is education. The computer has provided a lot of facilities in education system. The computer provides a tool in the education system known as CBE, computer based education. It involves control, delivery and evaluation of learning. There are a number of methods in which educational institution can use computer to educate the students. It is used to prepare a database about performance of a student, and analysis is carried out on the basis. So, example, educational institutions will be using any softwares such as educational package, which includes all the fees payment, all the details will be included. Now, let's move to the second application. Computer is used business. Computer is used in business organization such as payroll calculation, budgeting, sales and analysis, financial forecasting, managing employee database, maintenance of stocks, etc. Banking. So, in banking, computers are used vastly for storing the database, and there are many software such as banking software. All the details will be stored, such as overdraft, current balance, deposit, and all the ATM details will be stored in the server. For each and every bank, there will be a server which will be connected to multiple clients. Example, State Bank of India. There will be a server for the system in which, example, if it is located in Chennai, all the sub-branches which is located in Bangalore, Kanyakumari or Tamil Nadu side. So, all the requests will be sent to the server so that the information can be easily shared. Today, banking is almost totally dependent on computers. Bank provide the following facilities. Banks provide online accounting facility, which includes current balance, deposit, overdraft, interest change, shares, and trustee records. ATM machine are making it even easier for customers to deal with banks. Marketing. In marketing, uses of computer are as follows. Advertising. With computers, advertising professionals create art and graphics, write and revise the copy, print and broadcast ads with the goal of selling the core products. Here, there are many softwares such as Flash, Photoshop, Adobe Flash. Based upon this, the designing can be done and it can be used for marketing purpose. At home shopping. Home shopping has made possible through the use of computerized catalogs and provide access to product information and permit direct entry of orders to be filled by customers. Example, Flipkart, ShopClues, Amazon. We can order online and purchase the items with the help of our computers. Healthcare. Computers have become important part in hospitals, labs, dispensaries to prepare the reports or to generate the reports or medical billing. For each and every hospital, there is a software called as hospital management system, which contains all the details about it. The computers are being used in hospitals to keep record of the patients and medicines. It is also used in scanning and diagnosing different diseases. ECG, EEG, ultrasounds and CT scans are also done by computerized machine. Some major fields of healthcare in which computers are used are diagnostic system. Computers are used to collect the data and identify the cause of illness, lab diagnostic system. All the tests can be done and reports are prepared by the computer. Patient monitoring system. These are used to check the patient signs from abnormality such as cardiac arrest, ECG, etc. Pharma information system. Computer checks drug labels, expiry dates, harmful drug side effects, etc. Surgery. Nowadays, computers also involved in performing surgery. Now, let's move to the engineering design. One of the major areas is CAD, computer-aided design. That provides creation and modification of images. Examples, structural engineering requires stress and strain analysis for designs of ships, building, budgets, airplanes, etc. Industrial engineering. In industrial engineering, computers deal with design, implementation, and improvement of integrated systems of people, materials, and equipments. Architectural engineering. Computers help in planning towns, designing buildings, determining range of buildings on a site using two-dimensional and three-dimensional drawings. Now, let's move to the communication. Communication means convey a message, an idea, a picture or a speech and receiver to the corresponding destination. Some main areas in this category are email, which stands for electronic mail, chatting, Usenet, FTP, which stands for file transfer protocol, Telnet, video conferencing. Now, let's move for the another application, government. Computers play an important role in the government. Some major fields in this category are budget, sales tax department, income tax department, male and female ratio, computerization of voters list, computerization of driving licensing system, computerization of PAN card, etc.